Hello everyone, in previous video I told you exercise 9.1 from M.L. Agarwal. In this video I will explain exercise 9.2 from M.L. Agarwal. It is the last exercise of this chapter. In this exercise, first question is given. Identify each of the given pair of angles as alternate interior angle, co-interior angles or corresponding angles or none of these in the given figure. Clear? First of all, we will make figure. Whatever figure is given there, that I will make. Clear? It is a transversal line. Angle is given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Clear? And in question number 1, 6 part is given. First part is angle 2 comma angle 6. Clear? Angle 2 comma angle 6. It is which angle? Clear? Angle 2 and angle 6. It is corresponding angle. What we will write? Corresponding angle. Clear? Now second part, angle 1 comma angle 6. Angle 1 comma angle 6. See, angle 1 and angle 6. It is not any angle. Means we will write here none of these. And third one is angle 3 comma angle 5. Angle 3 and angle 5. It is alternate interior angle. Alternate interior angle. Clear? Fourth one is angle 2 comma angle 7. Angle 2 and angle 7. Angle 2 and angle 7. It is also none of these. Clear? Fifth one, 3 and 6. Angle 3, 6. Angle 3 and angle 6. It is co-interior angle. Co-interior angle. Clear? And 6 one, 4 and 8. Angle 4 and angle 8. It is which angle? It is also corresponding angle. Corresponding. In part 1, I given introduction in part 1. Please, that video you listen carefully. Then you understand what is corresponding angle, what is co-interior angle, what is alternate interior angle, what is alternate exterior angle. That I told you in part 1. Clear? And in your book also given here. In your book also given corresponding, co-interior, alternate. That from there you can see also. And I also told you. Note down this. Question number 2 you can do. Like question number 1. Clear? Question number 3. In each of the following figure, a pair of parallel lines is cut by a transversal. Find the value of this. Question number 3rd one. Clear? It is given like this. Clear? It is a 100 degree. It is a yes. Clear? Asking find the value of this. I told you corresponding angle. About corresponding angle I told you, means x equal to 100 degree, it is corresponding angle. Clear? What is the answer? This question solution is only one line. X equal to 100. Why? Because it is corresponding angle. Note down. Third second. It is given here X. And here is given 110. Clear? It is asking find the value of X. I told you co-interior angle. You can write here X plus 110 equal to 180 degree by co-interior angle. Clear? Means if any angle in transversal one side is there, clear? That is co-interior angle. Clear? Means X plus 110 equal to 180, X equal to 180 minus 110, then X equal to 70 degree. X equal to 70 degree. See? X and 110 is given. We have written here X plus 110 equal to 180, then X equal to 180 minus 110. That is 70 degrees. Note down. Question number third part you can do. Question number four, it is also very easy. Clear? Here is given 2x plus 6. Clear? And here is 3x plus 5, sorry, 54. In figure, it is 2x plus 6 degree, it is 3x plus 54 degree. In the question is asking, find the value of x. We know that it is co-interior angle. Means 2x plus 6 plus 3x plus 54 equal to 180 degree by co-interior angle. 2x plus 3x, 5x plus 60 equal to 180. 5x equal to 180 minus 60. 5x equal to 120. Then x equal to 120 by 5. 5 to the 10, 5 4 the x equal to 24. Again, I am explaining. 2x plus 6, 3x plus 54. It is co-interior angle. Here, we know that co-interior angle sum is 180 degree. 2x plus 6 plus 3x plus 54 equal to 180 by co-interior angle. 2x plus 3x, 5x plus 60 equal to 180. Then 5x equal to 180 minus 60. 5x equal to 120 degree. Then x equal to 120 by 5, x equal to 24. Note down. Second part you can do. Students, question number 5. In the following figure, 1 to 4, a pair of parallel lines are cut by transversal. Find the size of each lateral angle. Clear? In question number 5, total 6 part is given. Clear?
First part I am explaining. Two parallel line is given. Clear? And it is a transversal.
Clear to you?
It is a 60 degree X and it is a Y.
Clear? Then how you can find the value of X and Y? I am explaining you.
X equal to, you can write 60 degree by vertically opposite angle. By vertically opposite angle. Then here is X equal to Y by corresponding angle. Y equal to X corresponding angle. Then y equal to 60 degree. x equal to 60,
y equal to 60. Clear to you?
Note down.
Students, second part you can do like part one. Third part I am explaining you. Third part is two parallel line is given. Two parallel line given like this. Clear? It is a A, it is a B. No, here is not B. B here is given. Clear? And 70 degree here is given. Clear? Asking find the value of A and B. Very simple question. See? A equal to 70 degree. A equal to 70 degree. Why A equal to 70? Alternate interior angle. Clear? Then B plus A. Sorry. A plus B equal to 180 by linear pair. A equal to 70 plus B equal to 180. Then B equal to 180 minus 70, B equal to 110. Means A equal to 70 degree, B equal to 110 degree. It is simple. And fourth part you can do like question number 3. Note down. Fifth part is two parallel line is given. Clear? And one transversal line. It is a A, it is a B, it is a 75 degree. Clear? And here is C, here is D. Clear? What we can write? It is a very simple question. A plus 75 equal to 180 degree by linear pair. Clear? Then A equal to 180 degree minus 75, so A equal to 105. Clear? B equal to 75 by vertically opposite angle. Clear? C equal to 75 by corresponding. Corresponding angle. Clear? And for angle D, D equal to A, alternate exterior angle. B equal to 105. Means A equal to 105, B equal to 75, C equal to 75, D equal to 105. Clear? Note down this. Question number 6. Question number 6 is, here is given figure like this. In the adjoining figure, in the adjoining figure, A, B, C, D, E, F. Clear? And angle is given. It is 120, it is X, it is Y, and it is 140. The question is asking if the adjoining finger line AB, CD, EF are parallel. Calculate the value of X and Y. Clear? X and Y. Clear? Very simple question. Listen how. X plus 120 equal to 180 by co-interior angle.
x plus 120 equal to 180 degree by co-interior angle x equal to 180 minus 120 x equal to 60 means x value is 60 clear for y same process y plus 140 equal to 180 by co-interior angle why you are writing co-interior it is on same side clear then y equal to 180 minus 140 y equal to 40 degree clear asking angle ECA so angle ECA means x plus y clear x plus y means x equal to 60 y equal to 40 equal to 100 degree means angle ECA equal to 100 angle ECA equal to 100 degree first listen carefully x plus 120 equal to 180 co-interior angle then x equal to 60 clear here is y plus 140 equal to 180 clear then y equal to 180 minus 140 equal to 40 degree clear it is the value of x and y x equal to 60 and y equal to 40 both answer clear angle ECA means both variable it is divided in two part ECA divided in two part x and y x equal to 60 y equal to 40 60 plus 40 equal to 100 degree then angle ECA equal to 100 question number 7 you can do like that note down question number 8 first is easy second I am explaining you clear it is a triangle clear to you it is angle A 72 degree B 55 degree clear in this question asking find the value of A B and C clear first of all we will find the value of B B equal to 55 degree by corresponding angle clear it is a corresponding angle after that angle C equal to 72 alternate angle clear and angle A how you will find angle A sorry again I am telling you clear angle A equal to 55 by corresponding angle clear angle C equal to 72 degree it is a alternate angle alternate interior and you want to find angle B you know that it is a triangle you know that clear you know that it is a triangle the angle A plus B plus 72 degree equal to 180 degree sum of all angle of triangle is 180 clear to you then A value is 55 plus B plus 72 equal to 180 B plus 72 plus 55 127 then B equal to 180 minus 127 then B equal to 53 means A equal to 55 बी इक्वल टू 53, सी इक्वल टू 72.
क्लियर. अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू, एंगल ए इक्वल टू 55 बाय करस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल, एंगल सी इक्वल टू 72, इट इज अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल, एंड सी इट इज अ ट्रायंगल. क्लियर टू यू, इट इज अ ट्रायंगल. एंगल ए प्लस बी प्लस 72 इक्वल टू 180. वाई? सम ऑफ ऑल एंगल ऑफ ट्रायंगल इज 180 डिग्री. ए मीन्स 55 प्लस बी प्लस 72 इक्वल टू 180, बी प्लस 127. हाउ 127? इफ यू विल डू सम ऑफ 72 प्लस 55 यू विल गेट 127 इक्वल टू 180. देन बी इक्वल टू 180 माइनस 127, देन बी इक्वल टू 53. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, थर्ड पॉइंट. टू पैरेलल लाइन इज गिवन. क्लियर. गिवन लाइक दिस. क्लियर. इट इज अ डी, इट इज अ सी, इट इज ए 75 एंड इट इज बी. क्लियर. क्वेश्चन इज आस्किंग फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ ए बी सी डी. क्लियर. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू सी हाउ विच वैल्यू यू कैन फाइंड वेरी इजिली. क्लियर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ ए. ए प्लस 75 इक्वल टू 180 बाई लीनियर पेयर. ए इक्वल टू 180 माइनस 75, ए इक्वल टू 105. क्लियर. बी, बी इक्वल टू 75 डिग्री बाई अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल. क्लियर. एंड बी इक्वल टू डी, डी इक्वल टू बी करेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल. डी इक्वल टू 75 एंड सी इक्वल टू डी बाय अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल. तो सी इक्वल टू 75 मीन्स ए इक्वल टू 105, बी इक्वल टू 75, सी इक्वल टू 75, डी इक्वल टू 75. क्लियर टू यू, इट इज अ वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन. सी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू विल फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ ए. ए प्लस 75 इक्वल टू 180 बाई लीनियर पेयर. क्लियर. देन ए इक्वल टू 105, बी इक्वल टू 75 अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल, D equal to B by corresponding angle, D equal to C alternate interior angle. Clear? Now it is clear. And question number 9, you can do this type question we have done in NCERT 5.2 last question. And those who are same that you will not do, those who are change that question you will do. This chapter is completed in this book also. Okay? Thank you students.